Hey, what's up? Adam Lobo here from Adam Lobo TV. So I have been testing out the Apple Watch Series 7 for about a month to really test out the watch fully instead of just testing it for a week like how a typical review would normally be. Because in this in-depth review, I'll be telling you my entire experience using the watch every single day, and I'll also be showing you some cool features like using the watch as a viewfinder for your phone's camera, the awesome assistive touch and gestures, and more, which you may or may not know about this watch, so keep watching. First, let's start with the unboxing process of the Apple Watch Series 7. Now, the box comes in white with the Apple Watch logo on top. Then, turning the box around, it shows the exact specs of the watch that you have chosen, where for me is the stainless steel case and the 45mm size variant as well. Next, you'll need to slide open the box tab at each side. That will reveal another box inside with the watch face logo on top. Then below that box, there's the starlight colored sports bands box over there as well. But I've also gotten the silver Milanese loop band to give it another option for me to wear for casual wearing situations, which goes very well with the stainless steel case. Now going back to the main box, where if you turn it around, you'll find two green tabs also at each sides. Once that's taken off, you can turn the box back in front. Opening the box, there's the usual paperwork and the manual on the right side of the box. Underneath, there's the newly introduced USB-C MagSafe charger for the watch, which supports fast charging. Then finally, the watch will be available on the left. Now, if you're coming from a previous generation Apple Watch, firstly, don't forget to back up the watch under your iCloud settings first. Then unpair that watch. Next, bring your brand new Apple Watch Series 7 to your iPhone and pair it accordingly by following the instructions. Yep, it's super simple. So as mentioned and as you have seen, the variant that I have chosen is the 45mm stainless steel version. It goes so well with the look of my iPhone 13 Pro Max in silver, as it does seem that both were made for each other with a nice shiny stainless steel sides. Now you'll find the design to be very similar to the Series 6, but it has even more rounded edges and there's also a very nice wrap around effect for the screen as well. And I'm sure that you may or may not notice that this signature looking squared and the curved design has become so popular that you may see so many other brands following the exact design. And if you don't believe me, go look it up. Now, in terms of the durability, the new Series 7's front crystal glass is more crack resistant as it is now 50% thicker than the previous generation and is also now IP6X dust resistant, in addition to the usual water resistant up to 50 meters that we have seen in the previous Apple Watch prior to this as well. Now, other than the touch navigation, there is also the similar digital crown and also the side button over here. Then at the back, you'll find all of the sensors for the heart rate monitor, the ECG monitor, and the blood oxygen monitor. Now, in terms of comfort, wearing this watch daily, I have only tried out two types of the watch bands. Firstly is this Milanese loop, which almost felt like I did not have the watch on my wrist, since it does wrap around nicely with this very premium stainless steel mesh design. And since it has a magnetic clasp, it is super easy to adjust as it sticks on the stainless steel loop. Where once again, I do use this strap every day, including when I'm sleeping, except when I'm working out, where I switch it to my Starlight Sports Band or the white sports band version, which is actually the Series 6 watch band, which also fits with the Apple Watch Series 7. So that was sweet. Now, if you'd like for me to test out other type of the watch bands, do let me know at the comment section below and I'll revert over there on how exactly it was. Now, in terms of the watch screen, it has a 1.9-inch Retina LTPO OLED display. And compared to the previous generation, the new screen size is about 20% bigger. And although 20% seems like it's a minor difference, but trust me, it is very noticeable, especially the bezels around it, where the display has a way more screen real estate with the larger icons as well. And as for the screen's brightness, it has up to 1000 nits of peak brightness, making it super great during a very bright daylight situation, where the ambient screen or the always on display has also made slightly brighter compared to the Apple Watch Series 6. And during my overall usage, not only the screen was nice and sharp and bright at the same time, there was never a point of time where I felt there was any issues when it comes to the touch responses during navigation. And here's where I feel how the display quality is really premium indeed. Now, as for the watch software, the Apple Watch Series 7 comes shipped with Watch OS 8, where the version that I am at during the recording of this video is version 8.1. And exclusive to the new Apple Watch Series 7, there are three new watch faces, which is Contour, that has a clock number at the edge of the screen, where this particular watch face really shows how the screen has really stretched out now. Then there is the Modular Duo, which is my second preferred watch face, where I have edited mine to have the activity rings at the top left, my schedule in the middle, and my activity of the day down below. Then finally, there's also the Portrait watch face, where you can use a photo of your choice. And speaking of portrait images, what's new on this Watch OS is that now you can view photos on the watch in high quality, and you can zoom in and out of the photo by turning the crown of the watch. And finally, also what's new on the Apple Watch Series 7 is the QWERTY keyboard to reply a text, where even using the slide feature was very accurate. Some say it was not, but I find it very accurate. Now, I know that this particular feature is something that other smartwatches has, where as usual, when Apple brings in a software features to their hardware, even though technically it is late, but they do a damn good job at it. Alright, now that I have highlighted what is new and cool about the watch, let me give you my experience using the watch daily. So as a new user of the Apple Watch earlier this year, the number one thing which I love and cannot live without coming from the Apple Watch Series 6 to the 7 is the super addictive and motivating activity rings. And oh my god, words cannot express how obsessed I am with closing all of the rings daily, where at this point in time, I'm actually at my daily streak, and there was this funny story where I was at a shopping mall where I had a movie to go to, and I felt that I could not complete my move ring, and I actually did a slow jog around the mall. Yep. Freaking obsessed. Now, just in case you're new to the Apple Watch and have absolutely no idea what I'm talking about, well, the Apple Watch consists of the move, exercise, and the stand activities, which is calculated according to your metrics, and you can always adjust it accordingly to make your target higher or lower. Where my move activity daily is at 850 calories, the exercise target of mine is 60 minutes, and the stand target is at 8 hours. And speaking of working out, I also love using the Apple Watch for the Apple's Fitness Plus daily, since Apple has just got it available here in Malaysia. And I'm absolutely hooked with Jamie Ray's treadmill rock music team workout. And I also had a nice walk with Naomi Campbell sharing her stories, which I shall not spoil it for you, but do check out this cool time to walk feature also available on the Apple Fitness Plus. And also, since I'm back at the gym, my favorite weight training app, since I've been using the Apple Watch Series 6 earlier this year, is the Fitbod app, which I've done an entire video review of the app, which I'll link in down below together with my 25% promo discount over there as well. And the next best experience how I use the watch daily is for sleep tracking, which I know for a fact that I lack the most. So I try to sleep as early as possible, and the wind down feature in the health app goes very well with the Apple Watch together with my iPhone 2. Now, speaking of using the Apple Watch Series 7 daily, let's talk about the battery life of the watch. Now, in terms of specs, it comes with 309 mAh of battery, which is bigger than the Series 6. And as seen in the unboxing, there is now fast charging, since the MagSafe charger is a USB-C instead, which can charge from 0 to 20% in just about 10 minutes or so. But keep in mind that this wireless charging is only available through the MagSafe charger, as there's no Qi wireless charging. Now, battery life on this Series 7 though is a huge upgrade compared to the Apple Watch Series 6, where although Apple claims that you can get up to 18 hours, I got a total of 24 hours plus on this Apple Watch Series 7, as seen in this screenshot over here. And this is by clocking in 2 whole workouts daily, which made the watch lasted roughly about 1.5 days. Yes, there are other smartwatches which has a better battery life compared to this. But again, we are talking about the entire experience of the watch. And as a person who sleeps with the Apple Watch, since the watch supports fast charging, I can typically charge the watch after my workout, while I'm taking a shower, having my quiet lunch, and then I'm all set. Now, before ending this video, allow me to give you some quick tips and tricks using the watch daily, whether or not you're a new or a current user of the watch, and this also may be something that you may or may not know. Firstly, if you want Siri to announce the time for you, just touch the watch face with two fingers, where you'll need to activate this on the clock settings on the Apple Watch in case it's not activated, just like this.
4:28 PM.
Now, tip number two is to use the Apple Watch as a viewfinder for your phone to take high-quality selfie shots to make sure that you're in frame. And here's where you can set a 3-second timer and to go through other settings over there as well. And another bonus tip over here is that you can actually take the Apple Watch and strap it at the back of your iPhone, which makes this a perfect accessory for vlogging as well. As for the next tip is to use the Apple Watch as the nightstand mode, where once you toggled it, if you have your phone next to your bedside, it will turn into a bedside clock. And if it's turned off, you can just knock the table, which reveals the time, so no need for a bedside clock anymore. Then tip number four is obviously very useful for the present day situation, which is to use the Apple Watch to unlock your phone if you have a mask on, where you can activate that through the Face ID and the passcode settings. And you can even unlock your Mac as well, where you'll find these settings at the system preferences under the security and privacy settings. Then the final tip is to use the assistive touch features, where once again you'll have to toggle it under the accessibility settings. Then you can clench and pinch to navigate through the watch, and double clench to answer, or a single clench to end the call. Now yes, this clenching and the pinching gestures does take a bit time for you to get familiar with, but once you do, you will feel like a Sith Lord. Now, in conclusion, I have to say that if you own an iPhone, getting the Apple Watch Series 7 is simply a no-brainer. And my overall experience indeed was the cherry on top, testing the whole Apple ecosystem for the whole entire year. And it's nice to depend on this watch to do watch things and more. And if you want an experience that you know that you can trust, then this Apple Watch Series 7 does exactly that.